The Buddha, in his very first sermon to these cultivated disciples, gives this teaching, there is suffering. And then he says, it should be understood. This is the practice to understand, to know, to fully recognize suffering, not to just react to it, run away from it, blame it on somebody else, like we tend to do. I suffer because it's too hot, or I suffer because of my wife or husband, my children, or I suffer because of the political system. We love to blame everyone else for our unhappiness. So it's a blaming society. You know, if the government was perfect, if the national health system was perfect, if my wife or my husband was perfect, then I wouldn't have any suffering. But even if that all came true, you still suffer because there's this not understanding, not having developed wisdom, not having looked into the nature of things, even under the best, the most auspicious and pleasant conditions we can possibly expect as a human being, there'd still be dukkha or suffering. Now that can sound pessimistic to many people, but it's not. It's a changing your direction from just running around trying to find happiness and running from suffering to looking at suffering, saying there is suffering. Yeah, it's like this. And when I say it in this way, it's not like liking it or approving, but you recognize that the mental state, you're not looking at suffering as if it's happening out there. You're not blaming the weather or somebody else, not that. You're looking at your consciousness, the reality of consciousness in the present moment, and you can realize the doubt, the fear, the resentments from the past, the anxiety about the future, worry, dread, disappointment, despair, grief and loss. All these are part of a human experience. And then all of us have to deal with old age, with sickness, with the death. We have to cope with the loss of loved ones, seeing our parents grow old and get feeble and die. It's just a part of human experience. And yet we suffer from this because we don't want it to be like that. We don't want to have that happen to ourselves. In terms of the reality that all human beings face is that we all cope with the changing of conditions, what's born, what grows up, what gets old, and what dies is just the nature of things. That's natural phenomena. It's nothing wrong, bad, or it shouldn't be otherwise. It's looking at it from the wisdom level of mindfulness by seeing that all conditions, all phenomena are in this incessant changingness. So the Buddha emphasized over and over in his teaching that all conditions are impermanent.